are at the refugee center at the airport in České Budějovice, and I'm going to give you a tour how it works here. It actually is very impressive. They did a great job. In like a couple days, they set up this center in České Budějovice to process the refugees, and actually everything is under one roof. So they come, here you have the information center, they get a number, they get the instructions and everything, and then they move on to number two, which is housing. So if they don't have housing, then they inquire here and they get housing. A lot of the refugees already have housing allowed. They have housing through some family members or friends. The ones that don't, then they come here and they get the housing. There's several types of housing. One is state housing. They have a county housing. They have private housing, so they get housing. Once they have housing, they move on to number three, which is health. So at the health is number three over here. At the health, that's where they, you know, if they have any infectious diseases or any problems. So, you know, if they have vaccination records or whatever. So they go here. The next one is an important one. That's the foreign police. So here, you know, they show their documents and here they process them, they check them, you know, that make sure that they're legitimate refugees, that some are not criminals, because of course every crisis is being used by people, criminal elements and stuff, or people that are not refugees. So here they check them out. So it's the foreign police, what it's called. So it would be like the in America, customs and border. So yeah, the foreign police would be more like the customs and border enforcement. Then you move on to immigration here, number five. That's where they get their visas, and they're issuing special visas right now for 3 months. It's still in process if they're gonna, according what happens, if they're gonna extend the visa or if they're gonna make them, like European Union talked about, a one-year visa. So right now they get a 3-month special visa over here. Then they move on to that is the employment office. So they move on here, you know, to get a job, and that's another special visa that they need, a work visa. And also it's not just an unemployment office, it's also like a social welfare office. So this is where they register and they get some financial help in the beginning. Couldn't find out exactly how much, it depends on family, how many kids, but they get some financial assistance. Oh, and here is the insurance, where they get the medical insurance card, and they get medical insurance, and they're getting medical insurance for free right now. When they come, they actually go to the information center, they get all their paperwork, but they don't do this round yet. They go first, before they make the rounds, they go back here. So they go back here. The airport now is not closed, but it's open for small planes, but the terminal is not working. This is blocked off because behind here are the scanning machines, like at a regular airport. So they blocked it off so the refugees don't go through it. But they go back here into another part of the airport. Once they get all their information at the information center, then they come here. And when they come here, they already have to have a number from the information center. They have to have this. That is the whole plan, a map, what they have to do. And so they give their number here. And then there's a volunteer translators here, you can see at the table. A couple families where they have to fill out all the documents. Let's try to get a little closer so you can see. So they even made these little booklets because the language Ukrainian, of course, is different than Czech. But the big problem also is that they have a different alphabet. We have Latin, they have Cyrillic. So it's a little complicated to fill out the forms. So they have these little helpful tools and the translators to help them fill out all the forms. Once they have all the forms and their number comes up, then they go what I showed you, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the whole process. Here there's a little children area where children can play. Besides the big cars, all the toys that kids can take if they want them. The toys are all from people donating brand new toys, and then they get refilled by donations. This is a staging waiting room. When a lot of people come at once, then they wait here. When there's a translator available to help them with the paperwork. They're supposed to, any time now, supposedly come 3 buses. So it's gonna be busy. They processed today like 400 people, yesterday like 465. And the first day, it opened on Thursday or Friday. The first day they processed like almost 300 people. But of course, the expectation is that more and more people are gonna be coming. The other place is right here. We have refreshments. And in the front room, we didn't show you, but there's also Red Cross, and here's a gentleman with a Red Cross. So they're back here, and they're up front as well, helping. And here, this is if the kids need to go to bed, or people need to take a rest. If they don't have anywhere to go before they find a place to stay, but also this is for like last night, a bus came at night. The airport for refugees is open 24, and that's why they can come here and rest. But the actual processing, those 6 steps, that's 12 hours from 7 to 7. So when they come, like last night, a bus came, so then they could sleep here, wait for morning, and you can see you got some, clothes and everything that's being donated and stuff for the refugees. Right now it's a little slow, but it actually is a very impressive what they have done here and how efficient they are, and they're improving. You can see all the instructions on the walls, QR codes, free Wi-Fi. Those are things to get to the foreign ministry and websites for instructions and everything.
Hello.
Ahoy. Díky, pánové, moc. Děláte dobrou práci. Díky.
Díky.
So here are some of the volunteers, if they don't mind being on camera. So a lot of people that work here are volunteers, or they work for the city or the county, but they still have to do their regular jobs, like the director I talked to. So she's running between 2 jobs. Chcete něco říct na kameru? Ne? Tak díky. The one thing I did ask the director and found out is that most of these refugees are from the western part of Ukraine, or even the eastern before the Russian military troops got there. They are escaping with anticipation that the Russians are gonna eventually maybe take over the whole country. There are only few of them, like Kharkov, that is under siege. So only few came from actually cities where the Russians are bombing and are already controlling. So that most likely will come. when the second wave of refugees that are actually coming from war-torn parts of Ukraine. So that's where they also try to kind of balance everything. They don't exhaust all their resources on the initial wave of the refugees.
To watch more informative videos, subscribe to our channel or go to www.tvr.media. To help the Ukrainian refugees, please visit www.icanrelief.org.